I'm very happy that the third edition of ATP Challenger Tour is on here in Bangalore. It has been a challenge for us also, because it's just as though it's the ATP Challenger Tour, challenge for the KSLTA to conduct this event successfully for the third time. We are now entering into the third edition. And it's possible mainly because of the great support from government and a lot of non-government organizations. Number of government organizations, state government have supported. Already Sunil has mentioned a number of organizations, particularly from the social welfare department, from tourism department, from youth services department, industries department. All these departments have supported greatly. Plus a lot of industry people have also supported this event. And that's how we are able to conduct this event. Otherwise, it would have been possible for us to host this event.
Good evening to everybody and members from the Lawn Tennis Association, and media friends, and friends from the government officers and the sports fraternity, and also those who are gathered here, and my friend Sundar Raj, Secretary of Lawn Tennis. This is a great occasion to be here, and I congratulate the Lawn Tennis Association for conducting this third edition. This motivates the young tennis players very much, and that too, my vision is that Bangalore should become sports hub in all respects and in all events. So recently, last Monday, that is on 3rd, our Honorable Chief Minister inaugurated the first ever mini Olympics for under 14 years, which started from Karnataka state, from Olympic Association and Government of Karnataka.
The Bangalore Open 2020, an ATP Challenger Tour event, is back in Bangalore with a bigger prize money of $162,500. And we have a draw of 48, so 48 world-class players from across 24 countries are participating in this event with 16 teams of doubles. So it's going to be a 1 week of wonderful tennis celebration and festival here at the Karnataka State Lawn Tennis Association. We look forward to, as we've always done our best to ensure that this event is organized in the best of manner. This year too, we have done our bit, and we really thank the Karnataka government to support this event in a very big manner. Apart from that, all the other sponsors, and we welcome all the sporting ambassadors from nearly 24 countries to Bangalore. And I hope they all have a good stay here and a good competition, and we're going to have a wonderful week of tennis here in Bangalore. And I hope all the Bangaloreans come out and watch this world-class tennis and get inspired. I'm sure all the young tennis players of the city will learn a lot watching these players. And the best thing to happen for this event is definitely the legend of Indian tennis, Leander Paes, who is selected that Bangalore Open 2020 will be his last ATP event on the Indian soil. And this is a great opportunity for us to celebrate his achievement over three decades.